dear children, so today we are at the conclusion of our chapter, the parliament, the fourth chapter of civics, that is the parliamentary government, the union legislature. So today we will discuss the last point of our chapter, and the last point here is the government in action. So we know that the government, the main function of the government is to make laws. Okay, so now the question comes that why do we need laws? So laws are basic rules and guidelines for living in the society. Imagine playing a game of football without any rules. There would be no concept of team and no concept of goals. Anyone, those who wants to play, can come and join and can play. It would be turned into a crowd of people chasing and aimlessly hitting a ball in whichever direction and without boundaries. No time limits, no fouls, no penalties and no referees. Accordingly, there would be no win or loss or a result. You cannot play any game this way. Similarly, even inside a house, a family maintains some rules. There is a routine that is followed, which is controlled by the head of the family. There is a set time to play, study and eat. You are expected to respect your elders. So, rules, whether oral or written, have to exist for smooth functioning of our daily lives. Similarly, society which has a large number of people has to have some rules to abide by, or else it would not be healthy and fair environment to live in. If everyone starts to live in his own way, it would be turned into something like animals living in a wild jungle. This is why any civilized society frames some laws, and then it has to have its own system to enforce the laws and bring the defaulters to book. Once the society frames the laws, they should be applicable to all, irrespective of caste, creed, economic or political powers. So, the next point is translation of felt needs into laws. So, you know, our needs are changing day by day. So, laws have to be changed according to the changing needs and time as society develops. The social order changes with time. Imagine 50 to 60 years back, there were hardly any cars or mobile phones. As time went by, the technology has completely changed the situation. And today, the traffic density is very high. And the Indian economy is one of the biggest market for mobile phones in the world. New laws and rules have to evolve to make the uses of road space and communication system. Therefore, the legal system has to be dynamic and change the laws as per the changing environment and ground situation. The Indian Parliament has enacted many new laws and amended some existing laws to suit the needs of the population. Parliament has enacted the laws that can be suited to the needs of the population. The elected representatives of the people, in the Parliament discuss various aspects of the society and frame new laws and bring changes and through the amendments in the existing laws. These are passed by the Parliament and enacted by the orders of the President. The next point here is people's role in demanding laws. So there are many situations where the attention of the parliamentarians is drawn by the population through media, public agitation, social activists and such organizations and groups who pile up support to seek amendments in the existing laws or for framing new laws. But whatever may be the situation, the means of drawing the attention of the government towards the discomfort faced by a particular section of population, the ultimate power to make laws or bringing changes in the existing laws is in the hands of parliament and in the hands of the president. So in the recent past, the pace of social change has increased, and that is why many laws have been amended or new laws are made. So let's have a look on some of the new laws that are made in the recent past. So one of those laws is Protection of Women Against Domestic Violence 2005. So this law was made in the year 2005. So this law was framed to prevent men from abusing women in their homes, as traditionally the women were considered inferior. This was basically a requirement of the society to give women equal power. So that's why this law was Protection of Women Against Domestic Violence was enacted by the government. So the next law here is Child Labor Act 2006. So this Child Labor Act was initially enacted to ensure that the children are prevented from being put into the work, difficult situations and hazardous labor work at a tender at a small age. Poverty was forcing people to send children to work rather than to send to the school to get education and grow up in a healthy environment. So now the government has made this law, Child Labor Act 2006, to prevent these children from being put into hard and difficult works. Next act is Dowry Prohibition Act 1961. So this Dowry Prohibition Act, this law enacted as there were large number of cases where young women were being killed after marriage for the greed of dowry. This was further amended to make punishment harsher to those who indulge in the social evil of the society. So, in recent times, the government has had to amend laws to adopt new legal procedure like PIL, RTI and Lokpal to meet the aspiration of the population. Now, the next point here is implication of laws. So, this is our last point now. The making of laws by the legislature is ineffective if the executive does not take strict steps to give effect to the laws. However, in doing so, the executive must remember that the purpose of making laws is to benefit the society, not to crush it. The people must also cooperate with the government to make laws effective. The people have the right to criticize a law that they find unfair. They may also protest against it through lawful methods. The government may then change the law if necessary. So, this is enough for today. And we have completed our chapter and in my next video we will discuss about the exercises of the chapter. So till then, thank you and have a nice day.